Hello everyone, today I am going to make a e-bike t-shirt design. These electronic bikes are really trending now, so I have done like 20 or 25 t-shirt designs on this e-bike niche. So I thought to share with you guys how to do this kind of designs. Now of course, if you have some premium subscription like Freepik or other website, you can get really lots of silhouette image for this e-bike, but I am just showing you guys how you can make your own vector. So I was searching like e-bike png and I found this image really good. So I'm going to take this one. Just I'm copying this image. I have that already in my paint.net software, so I am using here paint.net. you can see this is the okay dot is not sharing here okay sorry paint.net. you can just search on Google, you will find this software. It is free to use. So this is the image here. As you can see, this is not a transparent png here, so we need to make it transparent. So first step is take your magic wand tool. You can do this with Photoshop also. I am just using this software here and erase, delete. So this is just to erase the details that I don't want, or you can just do it normally without erasing the details here, because this is not important. So do something like this, then go to this effect and go to this multi threshold. If you cannot find this option, then you need to check my Facebook group for the files, because I shared those plugins. So if I increase or decrease the threshold from here, you can see the details in my images like being visible and invisible. So I want to keep it something like this much, maybe just to keep these details a little, not that spokes kind of things. I don't want them. So press OK. Now this is a silhouette image. So let's press Ctrl A, Ctrl C to copy that. Now if I bring that in my Illustrator like this, I can simply go to image trace and then silhouettes. So this will give me a silhouette image of that e-bike. Just like this, I can go to this threshold option, reduce or increase the amount of the details I want in the design, just like this. Okay, maybe a bit more like that. Don't worry, just keep it something like this. Click on this expand. So now it is expanded, and as you can see, I have the silhouette image. Now this is not looking very professional, of course, because we are not using any premium vectors here. But still you can fix that. So I'm pressing Ctrl E for the eraser tool. Then I can simply erase the part that I don't want, like these details here. I don't want them. I want them, but I will make them in my own style, just like this. So something like this. The main part of this bike is this area. This is the battery area, so it should be visible. Then it is representing a e-bike, not a normal bicycle. So that's it. Now for this area, we can simply press our shift B for the blob brush tool, make it smaller of course, like the size here. Then just we can simply join them together, just like this. It doesn't have to be a perfect image here. So that's it. Now for the text, how can you find text? So I was searching like e-bike t-shirts, and you can see there are tons of other designs you can find from this Google search. You can take ideas. So I am using this one, e-bike, like a normal bike but way cooler, because I made this text in other designs like a normal dad but much way cooler. So that's the text here I am going to use here. Now for this kind of designs, we need to first of all make sure that what will be the focus point of our text. So the first point of the text will be this e-bike, because this is a design for e-bike. So this should be the first focus point. Then you can just place your text any way you want. I'm just going to keep it a simple and minimal design. So for this e-bike text, I'm going to use a bold kind of font. So let's use something like Impact. Impact is a bold font, or maybe Impact 2.0. This has some grunge texture inbuilt, but let's use the normal Impact font. This is easily findable on Google, you can find that. So something like this. Let's break the font, and I want it to be like the same size wide with my cycle here, the e-bike here, just like this. Then I want to overlap it with my bikes, my e-bike here, because that will make a cool looking effect at that place. So that is good. Now for these two text, we can use that same impact font, recent and then impact. Let's make it capital like this. Okay, so we are focusing on this e-bike text. We can make another focus point on this bike text, because that is also something important. So this becomes a bit smaller in size, and that is easy to use. I am breaking that one also, just to keep it something like all together. Now I am going to make it just like that. That is good. Okay, let's take out this text. Press I for eyedropper. Click here. It will make that font and that style. So making this like this maybe. Okay, so at this point, as you can see, this is the design is looking right now. If you want to make it a something like square kind of design, this is going to be a long style design, because for this text, the middle text, the bike text, I'm making my focus point. Okay, so as you can see, this is now looking, this bike text is looking like looking bigger than this e-bike. That means it is not working. So we need to focus on our e-bike text. This should be the center point, not this one. So maybe I can just simply make it smaller like this, just to place it. Then if I bring that text like that, it is going to make it not that much long design. Like if I take a rectangle here, this should be the full print area of a t-shirt design, 4500 into 5400. So something like that, that will work. So for this area here, as you can see, this is now looking like this. So maybe keep that one, no problem. Now for this area here, I want to make it look like this part is, I want to make this part visible on top of my that text. So I am using the same old transparency option, just making offset path just a little bit, 3 pixel, 4 pixel, that's good. Cut it. Now select this text, paste in front. It is going to look like that. So that is good. Maybe there is some problem, like if I press shift M, I can see where it should be matched. So like this, that is good. I can hide that part. Okay, hiding that part is not looking good. So let's keep it just like this, no problem. So this is how it is looking right now. We can use something for this area to cover this designs. So for this kind of designs, we can use something related to the e-bike. E-bike is what about the, like it is all about the charging. It is a electronic bike. So let's use a rounded rectangle maybe, just like this. Then press shift X for making it stroke, not in fill mode. So that is good. Now I'm going to select my this one, this stroke. Let's go to object path, offset path, just bring that little inside. I'm in the minus value right now, just like that, maybe a bit bigger, something like this. Press OK. Now I have this as a outline stroke. This is a inside stroke. So select the inside one, press shift X. It is going to make it in fill color. So that is good. Now I'm going to take my pen tool. If I make the fill none, stroke none, I am going to get this. So let's click right this, like this, create a line here without any stroke or fill. Then press Alt and drag it down. Then press Ctrl D for make some copies. Now if I select them like this, they are here, but I cannot see, because they doesn't have any fill or stroke. So I am selecting these lines like this, then press Shift and click here to select that option also. So, or maybe just select them, make sure that they aren't on top. So let's cut, Ctrl F to paste in front. Now select this one. So I make sure that these lines are on top. So if I go to Pathfinder, okay, before going to Pathfinder, let's select this one like this, select them, make them stroke like this. just to give this area some like some space between these blocks. I am just making a battery here. So when these are in stroke mode, let's go to object, sorry, expand to expand them. Now they are not in stroke, they are in fill. So I need to select this one, like all of them, press alt and click on this minus front. It is going to cut those areas like this. So if you want to make these strokes a bit smaller, you can do that. Let's go to object and expand appearance. Now we have these shapes here, so they are now grouped together. Now I am going to select one of these, then press shift x, sorry for that, I need to ungroup them. Then if I select this one, maybe, then press shift x. Okay, sorry, when we are using this pathfinder tool, it is basically becoming a compound path. So go to object, compound path, and release. Okay, sorry for that, I need to select them all, then go to object, compound path, release. Now they are released. Now if I select this one, press shift x, it is going to look like that. Maybe make it a bit bigger. So this is just to make it, give it a feel like the battery is not full, kind of like it is not fully charged, something like a little empty, and then like this. So this is going to be the battery symbol for us here. We can just simply take our this rounded rectangle tool to make something like this, maybe a bit bigger in size. I am just making the top part of the battery. So now press I for the eyedropper, click here, it is going to convert into same stroke size. So selecting these two, press shift M for shape builder. Now I am pressing alt and click here, it is going to erase that part. Now I have this as a battery loop. So let's group them all together, make that a bit smaller so that we can fill that inside the area here, just like this. Now if this is becoming a bit bigger, so don't worry about that, because I just want to fill this area with something, so that's why I'm using this one. So if this is looking like a bit bigger, you can make it smaller like this, that is good. Now I'm selecting this one, this group, press alt and drag like this, it is going to, I'm making a copy here. Now select this three all together, click on this vertical align, then click on this distribute, horizontal distribute center. It is going to distribute the space between them. Now I need to fill the area, so I am selecting these three. Okay, there are some strokes inside that. Okay, the reason I made this two empty is because I want to fill that two in this side, just to give it a feel like it is not fully charged, and here it is fully charged. So something like this. I'm selecting these two, three. I am going to expand everything because there are some strokes in the design and I don't need that. So if I make them complete black, and if I can make that, then there is no black inside the design. So that is good. Now I am selecting these two, fill this area just like this. I can bring them a bit down. Now I can make this just a little up like this. It will show me that smart guide that it is completely in the, sorry for that, I need to zoom in a bit so that I can place that. Okay, let's do it in the other way. Let's select this three, make them group, select this three, click here on this vertical distribute space. It is going to distribute the space between them equally. So that is good. Now this is the design for me. Now if you want to make it like a cool looking design, you can add a lots more details in the design, but trust me, this is, you just don't need to make it a like complete fully vectorized elemental design every time. If you just can take a good message that is going to relate with your customer, then you can sell this design. Now this image is from Google, something like it. This is uploaded on TeePublic, so I am taking this as inspiration and I am making a like a very identical design to that, so it can be copyrighted for me. So let's do something special for this design. Like you can see, they are leaving this area empty, so that's the area I can target to make my design stand out. So I am going to First of all, sorry for that. I'm just making a line like this, little bit stroke, maybe 1 pixel. 1 pixel is good. Okay, before that, first step is not doing that. I rotate that, I don't need that. I want to just keep it simple. So let's create a line like this. Press on in the stroke box. Now if I create a copy like this, I can select these two, make them a group, go to rotation tool, click, press alt and click here, turn on the preview, make it something like that, keep pressing Ctrl D, just like that. So that's why I didn't take the details from my image, because I can always make this inside Illustrator, and that is really easy. And of course it is not just add some details in our design, it will just make this design not very identical to the original examples we are taking. So if I select this, this is really like really invisible kind of. So let's make it a bit bigger, something like 1 pixel or 2 point. So 2 point is good, not a problem. So if I bring that in this area, that is good. Now our bike has some details in the design. And of course for these areas we can do it like add some details to our design. So let's try something like, I shared a grand spec with you guys, so I hope that you guys have that texture. So I'm going to take this one, use this one in my design. I shared this version with you guys, and of course this textures also I gave, so I am using this one. So let's select this one, maybe let's copy that. Now we are, sorry, that was another design I was working. So if I select this text right like this, inside the transparency I can press Ctrl V to paste that texture. So if I rotate like this, I can put them like this to add some texture in our design, just to give it a feel like something advanced style. So let's copy one here, let's copy another one in this style. This is not a very much like professional looking vector works, but trust me, this kind of design is the one that sells most of the time. So that is the style. Now for this text here, I'm going to open the transparency for it. Now I'm going to, okay, before that I need to select one of these circles, so let's copy. Now if I select this one, okay, maybe select this one, this bike is a like bigger text than this one. So if I open the transparency, press Ctrl F, it is going to paste in that same place, but I want it to be something like in this area, maybe a bit bigger, so that it is covering the full area of my bike, just like this. I want to place the center point something like that, so it is looking a bit bigger. So let's make it smaller, 2 pixel is good for us. You can see this is how it is looking like, something effect applied on that area. So this is just to make it stand out from others. Now I want to select this, all this, I want to overlap it with my bike, just like this. This position is good. Now if I go select this one, go to transparency, I can simply select one of this, let's copy, click here. Now if I select my bike like this, I can open the transparency. Let's, okay, sorry for that. As you can see, this is a group, this is a group, my bike is a group, so I need to select all of them, make them group together. Then if I open the transparency, I can press Ctrl, let's press Ctrl V. Now it is looking like this. So I want to place it something like in this area, just like this, so that my text looks like it is on top of my design. So that is good. Now if I select this text, go to object path, offset path, maybe a bit, okay, this is in minus value, let's make it 10 pixel, just like this. 10 pixel is a bit bigger, 7 pixel, click OK, cut. Now if I select my this bike here, and inside the transparency press Ctrl F, it is going to hide this area like the overlapping area of my bike. So this is like now looking like a three layer design, like this one is in the background, then this one, then on top of this texture, on top of that. So the main point of my this design is you don't need to make it a huge vectorized work every time. Just a simple message placed in a simple way can make it a good design, because you are targeting a people or a community there. Like someone has a e-bike, he rides it or he loves it. So if you just can reach that man, you can see this is how it is looking right now. So if you can reach that man with this kind of message, then you can really, you can sell easily to this, to that person, because he will relate his personal life with this kind of style. And as you can see, this is looking like a 3D style, because that text is in the background, this text bike is on top of that foreground, and then this text is on top of my bike. So this is just looking from my point of view. I don't know if you can get that point or not. So this is just to give you an idea, guys, how to like research marketplaces. So as you can see, this area, always I keep telling that always give your time a little, give your designer a little time. So you can see this area is visible. So let's select our this group, only this star spoke groups. Open the transparency, then press N for the pencil tool, and make sure that your fill color is complete black. So when it is in black, you can simply draw it like this. And as you can see, when we are drawing something in black, it is going to hide that area. Click like this, and then if you want to take it to the advanced level, select this one, press shift B for the blob brush, make it a little smaller than it is right now. Just join these areas. Okay, sorry for that, it is looking like that. So I need to select this one, this bike, press shift B. And as in my one of my previous video, I showed you the draw behind. If you have draw behind, you have to uncheck that. It should be draw. Okay, sorry for that, it is drawing. But as you can see, I have a stroke mode. So if I select my bike like this, then make sure that you have fill mode selected, press shift B, and then you should, you can draw like this. Okay, that area is not drawing. So what is the problem? Okay, I was selecting the group maybe, so that is the problem. If I select this one, press shift B again, I can draw from this area. It's hard to understand sometimes, but you need to know the basics, then you can solve any problem you are facing, like this one. Okay, so this area is not looking very good. So let's press shift E for eraser tool, make it smaller like this. I can erase this part from here. Of course, I can erase this part also, just to make it look good. So that is not very important, guys. So this is right now my design looking. Let's select all of them again without this black rectangle, press Ctrl G to make them a group. Okay, I have, as I opened this grand structure, let's select this one, Ctrl C to copy. Now open the transparency for them, press Ctrl V. It is going to give us a look like this, just like this. I'm just making it a look little grand like that. Copy that one, then make another copy. You need to have a good configuration computer to make this kind of designs, because we are not erasing anything, everything we are applying inside the design. So guys, this is the final position of our design today. I hope this will give you some idea about the taking an image from Google and making your own design. So that's it, guys. Thank you, everyone. See you in the next video, guys. Thank you for supporting me.